In this video, I'm going to show you how to create Ubuntu USB bootable drive. To do that, first go to ubuntu.com. This is the official site to download software. Then go to Get Ubuntu, and then you can go to Servers, and you can download the server, or if you want desktop, you can download desktop, and you have the option to download all other options here. So I'm going to download server, Get Ubuntu server, and then you can click download and make sure you look at the system requirement and the USB drive space requirement also. This version of Ubuntu 24.04 TLS takes 2.6 GB of your USB drive. So click on download this version and your download will start shortly, and you can see it started here. Click on there and you can see I already have downloaded this version, which is 2.6 GB. So I'm going to cancel this download and go to my download drive. So I have that in here. So now the second part is we are going to make the bootable USB drive from this ISO file. So the next step is download the Rufus software, which is needed to create the bootable drive, and go all the way down and click on based on what's the operating system, and click on the version that fits your operating system. I'm going to click on this one that is for the Windows, and you can see Rufus has been downloaded. Let's go to here, and you can see Rufus 4.6 is here. It is a very small program. Double click on that. It has been installed now. So now we are going to create the bootable USB drive. So this is my source USB drive, which has a 16 GB of space. I'm going to select ISO image and go to select, and I'm going to point where my ISO image is located. It's going to be here. This is the ISO image. Now I got the image here, and I'm going to keep these as the default options, that is MBR for partition scheme and BIOS or UEFI for target system. And I'm going to rename the volume name, that is the image name, Ubuntu server. I'm going to erase this one and I'm going to say Ubuntu server 24.04. You can name anything that you want. I will keep these also as the default, and I'm going to click start. Disk image mode, Rufus recommend using ISO image mode. So I'm going to keep the recommended ISO image mode. Click yes. It started now. So it's going to take little bit of time. All data on this USB will be erased. That is fine. I have nothing on the USB. Click OK. Deleting partition. And now it is working on creating the bootable image. Now you can see it is copying the ISO file and going to create the bootable image. Even though the ISO file is 2.6 GB in size that we have downloaded, the bootable image is going to be more than that. So the basic requirement is you need to have 4 GB or larger USB drive, and you also need to have Microsoft Windows XP or latest version, and you also need to have the right Rufus version too. Boot drive creation now has completed. It took about 5 minutes, and let's see how it looks like in the USB drive. And this is everything you have in the bootable drive. So now I'm going to use this USB drive to boot into a machine and see how it works. I'm going to insert the USB into the USB drive and I'm going to see whether I can boot it from this USB. Let's turn on the Dell. I'm going to press F12 while it is rebooting to go into the boot menu. So now I'm going to boot from the USB storage device. Hit enter. There are two options, test memory, try or install Ubuntu server. I'm going to select the first option. Let's see, it is booting from the USB drive here. So you can see a bunch of logs going on. And you can see okay messages. That means it is booting from the USB. So this is how you make a bootable Ubuntu USB drive using an ISO image and Rufus software. I'm going to make another video on how to install Ubuntu server on your computer. So with that, I'm going to end this video. If you like this content, make sure you hit the like button. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and turn on the notification for my future video updates.